Back in the building, you're Julie J. Smooth on the one and two's doing what I do for the Vanessa Jasey Show. I'm the host.
Wait.
Co-host, you know.
Wait.
Hey, wait. She's on doing what she wait. Does. Hey. But we got my man Dashawn Taylor in the building, the author. In the building. What's up, my brother, big brother? What's going on, man? Hey, long
call,
time no see.
Absolutely, man. Still hustling.
You still hustling? You got the whole new look.
He's a hustler.
Oh, absolutely. The ultimate hustler.
The ultimate hustler.
Hold on. Before we go. Hold on.
Yeah.
Here we go. Everybody, meet Dashawn Taylor. All right, you guys. Meet Dashawn Taylor. Dashawn Taylor, meet you guys.
What's up, you guys?
Woo! Yes, he got it.
Oh, yeah.
A round of applause. Nice. All right, so Mr. Dashawn Taylor is an author here, everybody. He's been featured in Essence Magazine, Black and Noir Magazine, Unsigned and Undesigned, Don Diva Magazine, The Trentonian, thank you. The Trentine, New York Daily News.
Wow.
He's been on television as well, on The Ultimate Hustler, BET's reality show, another BET show, The Center, Scouting for Talent, and UPN News. So you've been pretty busy.
Always.
Now,
always.
You claim to be a hustler. What kind of hustler is this?
Everything except for illegal hustling. I mean, I do it all, man. Anything that, you know, that's entertainment, you know, if I do it, if I don't do it, I know somebody that does it. So, you know, I'm grinding on my hustle.
So you got money?
Do I got money? Well, I know people with money just as good.
Can they spread some my way?
Oh, of course. I thought you were trying to rob me, so I'm trying to avoid the question. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm new to the show, so I don't know if you guys pulling out guns later.
Why are we pulling out guns?
I don't know. Everybody's starving right now.
Hey,
gas prices.
The Vanessa Jasey Show, we don't do things like that here.
Okay, not yet.
No, we would never. We don't have to.
Wait till that gas, get the $5.
Let me tell you something. You know, that's exactly why I don't have a car note.
Oh,
okay,
nice.
So I can dump all my money in the gas if I want to.
Okay, all right.
I don't have full coverage insurance. I have liability.
Let me know where you're driving so I won't be next to you.
But that's what liability is for, is to cover you. What are you talking about? I'm just not covered.
I'm suing for millions, baby.
Well, sue. You ain't going to get much.
That's the hustler right there, everybody.
That's the hustler talking.
Absolutely. All about that paper.
Yes.
All about that money right now.
All right, so tell us about Dashawn Taylor. Who are you?
Well,
where did you come from?
Well, I'm from Trenton, New Jersey. You know, I'm Jersey born and raised.
You still live there?
No, I'm in Newark now.
Okay.
I'm a Newark boy right now. You know, all my books right now are basically geared towards Newark. Love Brick City. You know, I know a gang of people up here. I'm not going to shout people out. Y'all know who
y'all
are.
Are you in a gang?
No. I know a gang of people.
Oh, okay.
No, my gang, I'm in a legal gang now. You
hustling,
know, I'm a
legal
corporate guy.
Okay.
But, well, my background's always been entertainment. I actually started my little career when I was like 16. I was doing mixtapes way back in the day out in Trenton. Anybody know anything about Jersey and Trenton? You know,
Juice.
Poor Righteous Teachers, YZ.
Yeah,
no doubt.
My
Donald
time.
D. That's your time?
Yeah.
Okay. Should have came down there. You could have been in one of the videos. We loved you in
Trenton.
Well,
I'm not a video hoe.
No, you were
oh,
in
okay.
one of the videos.
Okay.
Video hoes are new things. Back in the day, there wasn't.
Video
hoes, that's a new thing. But so yeah, I actually started my career back then. I was a rapper, you know, MC Double D, Devastating Dashawn. I was part of this crew called
my.
The Love Posse. Yes.
Wait a minute.
Devastating Dashawn.
I can't even laugh because I had a name too back then, even though I wasn't a rapper, called Vicious V.
Exactly. See, that's what it was. You, whatever it was, it was it was an adjective first and then your initial.
Yes.
So you was like Dope David or something like that. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
It just so happened to be Devastating Dashawn, MC Double D.
Devastating Dashawn.
That?
You have a scar in your mouth? What is that
from? I got into a little
because you was in a gang
scuffle-itch when I was younger.
Not because you was in a gang.
No, no, no. Never been in a gang.
Oh, okay.
Do I have gang written on me or something?
Yeah,
like
your
that?
Shirt.
My shirt says gang?
Yes.
All right. Well, listen, man. My gang is George Washington, Abe Lincoln, Grant, Benjamin. That's my crew right there. My crew.
The flag is green.
Serious. But so yeah, so you know, after that, I actually went to school, went to Rutgers, you know, still Jersey, New Brunswick. Okay. And I actually had a little crew called the Madness. We actually started a promotion company. Mm-hmm. We did you know, videos, we did parties, all types of stuff down in Rutgers, New Brunswick, did Newark, the whole nine. But I actually started a website called realhiphop.com back in 2000. Okay. And I know y'all probably went onto the site back in the day. It was crazy. And then that's how I actually got onto the Ultimate Hustler show.
Okay.
Because I put out the Real Hip Hop magazine. So I've always been around entertainment and everything, and now I have the company, of course, Next Level Publishing, and I'm into, you know, publishing urban books, of course, mine first,
right.
You know. I'm working on my fourth book coming up. It'll actually be out July the 5th, mm-hmm. called Messy Sheets. It's going to be...
Messy Sheets!
Yeah, oh. I knew you were like that. Look at that face. Look at that face.
I haven't messed up any sheets in like 300 and something days.
That's
I've been
good.
Celibate.
That's not good.
You saw that face?
Not good.
No.
Let me tell you something.
Do you know how healthy that is to
Very.
Mess up your sheets?
No.
You know
Extremely.
How healthy that is?
No.
Extremely healthy.
Do you know how healthy it is to be celibate?
Ugh.
I am on my grind. I'm focused.
Oh.
I stay away from dirty, filthy, nasty, casual sex.
I wonder why she sounds like that.
Anyway, the book will be out July the 5th. She'll be the first in line to get it. We're going to make sure that the VJ show got it.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? You'll have a couple of copies
okay.
here. So, yeah, the publishing company is doing real well. You know, I got to shout out my, you know, my team. Of course, I got Harold Williams. He's the president out of D.C. Brilliant mind. Love him, you know, for the
Hold
fact
on.
That...
Before, I want to know what Messy Sheets is about first. Then we could talk about everybody
else. Interrupt my
yeah.
shout-out?
All right.
She does a lot.
Buzzed on a hip and everything.
All right. Go ahead. Do your shout-outs, and
okay.
then we'll get back to Messy
Sheets. My shameless
Sheets.
Plugs. Then I got my brother out in California. Shout-out to Mike. He was actually called Money Mike back in the day. Money Mike.
He has money?
He got a little bit of money.
Nice.
He got a little bit
you gonna
of
introduce me to him?
I might.
No. He gonna
be the one to mess up them sheets. Mike don't play that. Mike don't play
Is
that celibate stuff.
Is he tall like you? What size shoe you wear? 13? Is he tall?
Whoa. About to mess up this couch.
Anyway, get back to the shout-outs.
So the shout-outs, yeah. yes. And then my VP of marketing operations, Alicia Arthur. I think you talked to her, actually. She's the beast. She's the,
Alicia?
Oh, no, Trisha did.
Oh, Trisha did.
Yeah, Alicia's the beast. She's the brains behind the whole operation.
Okay.
But, yeah, my team is strong, man. We serious right now. I like the song, too. For life. I like me and him. We in tune right now. So I know you want to talk about the Messy Sheets.
Yes, Messy Sheets.
So the book is actually based in Newark.
Okay.
It's a young lady. Her name is Kimmy Moore, as in Gimme Moore.
Mm-hmm.
She's all about, you know, serious about her money, but she's actually involved with this married man, and things kind of get really, really hectic when they get too close, and, you know, secrets start to leak out, secrets start to get real serious.
Did she get pregnant?
I don't know. I don't know how the book ends. I think you got to pick it up and read it. And then it'll let you know.
Someone dies.
Of course.
Who?
Of course.
The husband.
People. I don't know.
People.
I don't know. You have to read it, Vanessa.
People. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You have to read it, Vanessa. You're so smooth.
So wait a minute.
You
got to
read that book.
You haven't read Kissed by the Devil yet?
No.
Okay, well, Kissed by the Devil is my first novel.
Okay, what is that about?
Kissed by the Devil is crazy. It's a young lady named... Yeah, thank you. I like that. See, my man, we in tune right now. We on that Newark stuff right now. So, Heidi is actually she's a young woman from Newark. She goes through a domestic violence dispute. First chapter of the book's crazy. Her fiance is really beating the hell out of her. And come to find out, he's involved in all this underworld stuff, crazy stuff. He winds up dying. This is all in the first chapter. You don't have to worry about it.
Mm-hmm.
Me telling the story. But it comes out that he's really involved in a lot of this crazy stuff. So as the story evolves, you know, her eyes begin to get open into a lot of stuff that he was into. Hence the term being kissed by the devil, because you really don't know who you're next to.
Right.
You really don't know who's
that's
the person
why I stay
that's
away.
In your bed.
That's
no,
right.
No. You can't stay away from everybody.
I am.
I don't know. I don't got a connection here. You know what I'm saying? We'll have a connection here because I don't.
Are you supposed to?
I don't comprende. You know? I don't. I don't understand. You don't fuck him.
That's why I don't allow anybody in my sheets or in my house.
That's cool. I mean, you can mess
up. That's why I'm right here where I am.
You can mess up some leather chairs inside of Eddie Bauer, you know?
No.
You don't have to.
That's not going down.
No, I feel
sorry.
You.
No lipstick in this pocketbook.
I don't know. I thought I was coming to a crazy show. Somebody told me this show was crazy. I'm not getting it.
She is crazy.
Yeah, she on the low. Let me bring that book out. Then I'm gonna start to get the real questions.
Now let me ask you.
Yes, ma'am.
Were you the fiance? Were you the one beating up on your girl?
How did this come about?
Is this your imagination or this is a real life stuff?
Let me tell you, my imagination is crazy. I've always been like this. Even when
you look like a woman beater. Let me see your arms.
No. Not a woman beater.
Oh, okay.
Not in a bad way.
Oh, okay.
Not in a bad way.
He don't beat that.
Something else.
No.
See this guy.
He'll beat that V.
No lipstick in his pocketbook. Go ahead.
I don't want your lipstick in this pocketbook.
It ain't going down.
Would you stop?
All right,
you
go ahead.
Crazy.
This is Vanessa. Welcome to the Vanessa Jasey Show.
Yes. I knew we'll open it up without the spirits.
Welcome to the extravaganza.
But no, it's really just being a writer, to be honest.
Yes.
I mean, if you're an author and you want to get into this game, just open up your mind. Don't put yourself in a box. Don't make your characters, you know, real stuffy and tight. I mean, explore. I mean, the biggest thing that I did, my biggest breakthrough was really when I stopped thinking about my characters as myself.
Mm.
Like, stop, you know, putting myself in the character's shoes and all that. No, I want to put myself, you know, I want to experience what they're experiencing. So now I'm trying to really widen the scope of what the books are about. So yeah, it's all creative. I mean, I'm not in a gang. I never shot nobody. I don't know what it feels to be shot.
But
I can research and actually figure that part out. So I don't really try to write too much reality, because you can get that in other places. I want you to come into my world, you know, and
your
my
crazy
books.
Head.
No doubt. I'll take that. I'll take the crazy head, because I like that. I want you to come inside and see all this craziness, you know what I'm saying?